Good evening, and welcome to the Bogota Junior Senior High School's commencement exercise of 2021. Graduates Shanaz Uden and Elsie Luque will now lead us in the flag salute, followed by Miss Luque singing the national anthem. We ask that everyone please stand.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Thank you. Allow me to introduce and thank those who made today possible. Superintendent of Schools, Mr. Damian Kennedy, our Business Administrator, Mr. Irfan Efsel, President of the Bogota Board of Education, Ms. Kathy Van Buren, who could not be here with us today as she is attending her granddaughter's graduation from Hamilton High School. Our Board of Education Vice President, Mr. Jose Chavez, Trustees Ms. Adalia Alvarez, Ms. Lisa Coles, Ms. Eileen Lewis, Mr. Frank Miranda, Ms. Amanda Montgomery, Mr. John Ortega, and Ms. Bissy Ruckett. We also have Vice Principal Dr. Eric Alfonso, Supervisor of Student Services Ms. Jill Connolly, Director of Research and Planning Mr. Sam Chang, and Mr. Nick Naturelli, who is our Head of Maintenance and Grounds. I would also like to recognize our senior class advisors, Ms. Joan Fry and Ms. Arlene Cragnola, our valedictorian, Ms. Shanaz Uden, salutatorian, Ms. Elsie Luque, and myself, Kelly Foley DiCongilio. On behalf of the graduates, I would like to extend a warm welcome to our guests who so graciously support us. This includes the Honorable Mayor Chris Kellerman and Bogota Town Council members, and the many faculty and staff who have come tonight to share in this great accomplishment with our graduates. I would also like to personally thank our guidance counselors and child study team, our teachers, our secretaries, our custodians, all who have played a part in making this happen. Additionally, I'd like to thank others who honor us with their presence and provided support throughout the years. Chief May in the Bogota Police Department, Bogota Fire Department, and Mr. Jim Moore in the Recreation Department, our PTO Executive Board members, and all of the members of the Parent Teacher Organization. I would also like to extend a special welcome to your family and friends and thank them for the support that they have provided to us over the lifetime of these very special graduates. The town of Bogota was officially founded in 1894, and we opened the doors of this high school in 1924. A lot has changed, but the hearts of these students has not. Today, this makes you the 94th graduating class, and I'm so proud to recognize and be a part of this rich heritage and to add 85 new graduates to the thousands who have gone before you. We bid them farewell with the certainty that they will continue to represent Bogota High School with an increased pride in themselves and their roots. Graduates, please sit. I now invite our superintendent, Mr. Damian Kennedy, to say a few words.
Good evening. For members of the class of 2021, today marks the end of your journey through Bogota Public Schools. The past 16 months have been a tough time for many families, but today we get a chance to celebrate your accomplishments together and face to face. You overcome many obstacles to be here today, and with support of BHS and your families, you sit here tonight ready to start the next chapter of your life. This year's graduating class was accepted into 75 different colleges, university, and tech schools, and accumulated over $4.3 million in scholarships and grant money. Very impressive numbers for only 85 graduates. I've had the opportunity of watching you grow from uncertain and nervous seventh graders to confident adults ready to take on the world. But before you do that, I would like to share a poem with you that I keep hung in my office that helps keep me focused on important things. It is titled The Bottom Line, whose author is unknown. The bottom line, face it, nobody owes you a living. What you achieve or fail to achieve in your lifetime is directly related to what you do or fail to do. No one chooses their parents or childhood, but you can choose your own direction. Everyone has problems and obstacles to overcome, but that is too relative to each individual. Nothing is carved in stone. You can change anything in your life if you want to badly enough. Excuses are for losers. Those who take responsibility for their actions are the real winners in life. Winners meet life challenges head on, knowing there are no guarantees, and give it all they got. And never think it's too late or too early to begin. Time plays no favorites and will pass whether you act or not. Take control of your life, dare to dream and take risks. Compete. If you aren't willing to work for your goals, don't expect others to. Believe in yourself. Bogota High School class of 2021, the bottom line is this. Whatever you choose to be in your life, be the best version that you can be. Good luck, and never forget where you came from. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kennedy. Our salutatorian, Elsie Luque, is a hardworking, smart, kind, and dedicated student with a very strong work ethic. She was an active member of the class of 2021, playing multiple roles in multiple bands, choir, drama club, and student congress, just to name a few, as well as volunteering in our school and our community. Next year, she will attend New York University on a full ride with a double major in philosophy and English and a minor in the classics. She knows all of this will prepare her for law school and eventually, as I am confident, a justice of the Supreme Court of the United States. It now gives me great pleasure to introduce the class of 2021 salutatorian, Elsie Luque.
Our esteemed superintendent, Mr. Damian Kennedy, our admirable principal, Ms. Kelly Foley DeConcilio, our respected vice principal, Dr. Eric Alfonso, dear members of the Bogota Board of Education, PTO, and Town Council, family, friends, and graduating class of 2021, have a good evening. I hope you're having a good evening, guys. All right. Love. That's what this whole speech is about. Love. I know you might be asking yourself,
What does love have to do with us graduating from high school? Well, I'm gonna tell you. There's this Bible verse that has always had a special place in my heart. 1 Corinthians 13:13. It reads, "And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love." I know this has been an incredibly hard year for all of us. Students, teachers, and parents alike. The world as we knew it was literally flipped upside down. For me, sticking by these three things helped me get through these tough times. The first is faith. Faith means having complete trust in something or someone. Maybe you have faith that God will help guide you and lead you to success. Maybe you have faith in the saying that goes, "This too shall pass," and you truly believe that all bad things will eventually come to an end. Maybe you have faith in others, and that for the most part, that people have good intentions and goodness in their hearts. And hopefully, you also have faith in yourselves, that you believe you can achieve anything you put your mind to. And if you don't have faith in yourself, you should. Look at where you are today. You are graduating high school and ready to take the next step in life. The second is hope. Hope means having the wish or desire for a certain thing to happen. As we moved on from the 9th grade all the way up to now, our last day of high school, I know all of us hoped for many different things. Maybe you hoped to beat a personal record in a sport you participated in or in your favorite PS5 game. Maybe you hoped to be the best you could be at playing your instrument. Maybe you hoped to improve your drawing technique. If you work a minimum wage job, which I know many of you do, maybe you hope for customers to not be so horrible to you, and for your boss to give you a pay raise and show you just a little bit more appreciation. And if you're like me, maybe you hoped for a future where we can all walk around without a mask on and not worry about getting COVID and getting your family sick. One thing is certain, in this past year and a half, I know all of us hoped that our friends and family would stay happy and healthy. But really, it all circles back to the word with which I started this speech, love. Faith and hope are all fine and dandy, sure. In fact, we need those two to fulfill the three essential things needed to have a joyous life. But without love, nothing else matters. If we have faith without love, we just have a baseless belief that brings us no joy. And if we have hope without love, we're just desiring an empty and lonely future. Love is a catalyst that drives us closer together. Out all of the things it is, I see an example of it in each and every single one of us. Love is patient. I see this in the love that our parents and guardians have for all of us. The patience that they show us when they pick us up late at night from a sports game or a band concert. When they go to cheer us on at a twirling competition or the fall play, even if they don't quite understand what's going on. When they push us to give 110% of ourselves and tell us to fight for what we want, for nothing in life will just be handed to us. I also see this in the love that our teachers have for all of us. They must have a lot of patience for choosing to deal with us every single day. Love is kind. I see this love every time one of you holds the door open for a fellow student. Every time one of you asks a teacher how their weekend was. Every time one of you takes care of your little siblings. And every time one of you sends your friend a text message asking them if they are okay. Love is selfless. I see this when one of you makes a touchdown and the entire team screams with joy. I see this in a volleyball match when one of you scores a point and all of the girls hype you up. I see this in the track and cross country kids when you still run and compete even if you're in pain for the sake of the team. I see this when we're walking down the hallway. We see a beautiful painting made by one of our lovely senior artists and I hear, "Wow, he's so insanely talented," or, "Wow, she was born to create masterpieces." I see this when one of us band kids have a solo and we all say, "You did amazing, hun. You rocked that solo." If one thing helped us all get here today, it's love. I know that I'm standing here before you all because of the love I have been blessed with, the love that I have been given from God, my parents, my best friends, my teachers, and all of you. Now that we have finally finished high school, I'm not gonna tell you that the only way to be successful is to stay in college, or if you're going straight to work, I'm not gonna tell you that the only way to be successful in life is to stay in that particular job. For all of those, in the grand scheme of things, are superfluous. As we've seen because of COVID, school, jobs, entire careers, all of those things come and go. However, what I am going to tell you you need is to be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid, and don't ever get discouraged. If there's anything that these past 4 years, especially this past year and a half, have shown us, is that we can conquer anything. I know that all of us, no matter what else life throws our way, will go on to do amazing things, and we will bring forth a shiny new light into this world. Oh, and one more thing I'm going to tell you. Don't ever stop loving, for there is one thing that never fails, love. And if we keep love in our hearts, then we can never fail. Thank you.
Thank you, Elsie. This year's guest speaker is a graduate from Bogota Junior Senior High School, class of 2014. Izamar, or Izzy, as I'm told she is called, served as vice president of her class, was a member of the National Honor Society, part of the Multicultural Club, a member of Student Council in the Math Club, and a varsity softball player. After graduating with honors in 2014, Izamar continued her educational journey, commuting to Rutgers Newark for the next 4 years, where she received her bachelor's degree. She immediately began Rutgers Law School and recently graduated with plans to practice family law. I am happy to introduce Bogota High School's own Izamar Plaza.
Hello and congratulations to the class of 2021. My name is Izamar Plaza, and it's so crazy to think that I was sitting where you're sitting 7 years ago. I first just want to thank the administration for allowing me to have this opportunity today. Secondly, I want to congratulate you all for completing this milestone. And I know that everyone is tired of COVID and nobody wants to speak about it, but I truly think that it's something that you should all note. Because as if high school wasn't already tough enough, you guys were forced to make it to the finish line during a global pandemic. Waking up and having to walk or drive to school was already a stretch, right? And oddly enough, waking up to roll out of bed, grab your computer, and log into class only made it seem 100 times harder. Trust me, I get it. But you should be proud because you did it. And I know that every person sitting here today has a dream. And I hope that this experience has showed you all what you are capable of. When I walked into Bogota High School many, many years ago, my dream was to become a lawyer. And I knew from way too young to even make sense that that's what I wanted to be. And while I always knew that that was my dream, I didn't exactly know how I was gonna get there. Fortunately, during high school, I realized that I was actually pretty good at school. So I challenged and dedicated myself. I joined every club that I could, I played sports, took honors, AP classes, and even got inducted into the National Honor Society. But even with all that, I still didn't know how I was gonna reach my end goal. While everyone spent their senior year stressing about choosing their dream school, I just assumed that I would have to wait a little longer. Because the truth is, college is expensive, and I did not have that money. But luckily, my counselor at the time, Miss Amana, shout out to her, she was not okay with that decision. And luckily for me, she didn't stop until she changed it. I remember being called into her office and thinking, oh God, what drama has someone dragged me into today? But to my surprise, when I walked in, she handed me a whole bunch of application waivers because applying is expensive too. She told me to have a seat and started plugging in numbers like a crazy woman. And before I knew it, I also joined my classmates in the stress of choosing a school. Because of the support I received at Bogota, along with my grades, which helped a lot, I was able to attend Rutgers University on a Fulbright scholarship. And after college, it was time for the next part of my journey, law school, which was by far the hardest thing I have ever done. But I never lost sight of my dream. And while there were several times that I doubted myself and even my ability, I continued to push forward. And because of that, I am proud to say that this girl who walked into Bogota High School all those years ago with a dream accomplished it. Because as of 3 weeks ago, this first generation graduate and Latina not only graduated from Rutgers Law School, but did so with a signed contract for her dream job. In the fall, I will be working in the Bronx, New York as an assistant district attorney. So please don't get in trouble there. Thank you. And I tell you all this not to brag, but to show you that to every success story, there is a foundation behind it. And to no surprise, my foundation was Bogota High School. Without Bogota, all my teachers and the guidance counselors, I would not be here today. And that is something that we all have in common, Bogota. So I urge you to remember the foundation that made you who you are today and who you become in the future. Like I said in the beginning, we all have dreams, big or small, we have dreams. And even if you come from a small town that no one has ever heard of, like Bogota, there's always room in this world for success. You just have to be hungry for it. So when the world tries to tell you that you can't, because it will, trust me, it will, show them that you can. And now, because it wouldn't be me if I didn't end with a message for all the women graduating today. You all know what we're up against in this world. You know that we have to work harder. We have to prove ourselves capable in a room where we are the most capable. So please do that. When you walk into a room, be loud, not with your voice, but with your presence. Break through all the glass ceilings in your way. And when you walk in, show them that you are not here to play. To the class of 2021, I wish you tremendous success in all your future endeavors. Please, let Bogota be your first step, but not your last. Congratulations, you did it.
That's a tough act to follow. Thank you, Izzy. This year's valedictorian, Shanaz Uddin, is a hardworking, determined, and confident young woman. She was an active member of the Drama Club, Garden Club, Junior Baxa, NHS, the Chess Club, and DECA, where she qualified at the regional competition and was asked to compete at the State Career Development Conference. In the fall, Shanaz will be attending Ramapo College, majoring in biology. It is now my great pleasure to introduce the valedictorian for the class of 2021, Shanaz Uddin.
Good evening, everyone. I'd like to give a special welcome to our superintendent, Mr. Damian Kennedy, members of the Board of Education, Ms. DeCongelio, Dr. Alfonso, and all administrators, the PTO, the town council, along with our senior class advisors. A warm welcome to parents and relatives, teachers and staff, and most importantly, the 2021 graduates themselves, both in person and watching the live stream. Do you all remember in March of 2020 when the school had decided to shut down for 2 weeks because of this new virus that was spreading? Just 2 weeks, we all said. Then we will be back to in-person learning. Boy, were we wrong. Here we are, a year and a quarter later, having just got off our last Google Meet for the year. I'm well aware that online learning has not been easy. This pandemic has thrown hurdle after hurdle at all of us. When you tell people that you are graduating this year, they always say, "Congratulations, you got through such a difficult school year." Indeed, it was more difficult than any of us could have imagined. Going to class from our kitchen dining table was not the hard part. No, it was going to class every day, knowing that your loved one was dying in the hospital and there was nothing you could do to stop it. A math test on Google Classroom and a Zoom funeral right after. It was knowing that your parents lost their jobs and had to apply for unemployment. Getting a job in your senior year suddenly was not just for the extra cash. It was helping your younger siblings get settled into their schoolwork while you struggled to just complete your own. It was the stress of the world falling apart, tearing at your mental health, your physical health deteriorating as the quarantine pounds climbed on and on. It was all of this plus all the trials and tribulations that come with being a normal teenager. We have been through a lot. I just want to say thank you to the people who made it a little better. Thank you to the teachers who were understanding when we showed up late to class and chose to not mark us down as tardy. Thank you to the teachers who tried to not assign too much homework so our eyes could get a break from the screen. Thank you to the teachers who gave a few extra minutes, a few extra hours, even a few extra days to do your tests. Trust me when I say that did not go unappreciated. I also want to say thank you to the Board of Education and the rest of the administration. One of the things I am so proud about our school doing is giving out free bagged lunches every single day this pandemic, even during winter and spring break. I also want to say thank you to the parents who supported their kids learning from home and tried their best to make it a little easier for them. Thank you to the friends who constantly called or texted to make this lonely quarantine a little more bearable. I know I speak for all the seniors here this evening when I say thank you. Thank you from the bottom of our hearts to all of you who tried to brighten up our day in such an isolated world. Even though you couldn't see our smile underneath our mask, know that it was there. Although our senior year did not go exactly as planned, I hope you can all still reminisce about your high school years with fondness. Look back on all your accomplishments and be proud of them. Savor the memories you made with friends, old and new. Use the lessons you learned in school, both the ones that were taught to you and the ones you figured out on your own. One lesson that I carry with me today was not taught to me in a classroom. I was listening to my teacher talk to some other students one day when she said, "When my daughters were younger, they were the perfect students. They crossed every T, dotted every I, always followed the rules. My son, on the other hand, was the kind of person to break a few eggs. He struggled in school. When my kids grew up and graduated high school and entered the real world, I realized my daughters were not as bold as my son was. They were too shy and reserved to assert themselves. My son, on the other hand, gained amazing opportunities because he was able to put himself out there." After hearing this, I realized that some of the lessons taught in school are imperfect when it comes to real-life application. In elementary school, we are taught to color inside the lines, not outside of them. However, in the real world, the people who experience the most success are the ones who are able to break free of their mold, to embrace who they really are. The lesson of how to flourish as your own person is one that we have to learn by ourselves. So, be bold. Think for yourself, even if it means thinking against the grain. Stand up for your beliefs when you know they are right. Color outside the lines, because only by coloring outside the lines can you create a new work of art. It will not be easy. As famous businessman Warren Buffett said, "People will always try to stop you from doing the right thing if it is unconventional." Whenever I personally have tried to voice a different opinion, I have been discouraged by those who disagree with me. I have even been told that I would never be successful in my career just because I stood up for myself. When children bully you and you stand up for yourself, they tend to leave you alone because they don't feel powerful anymore. When adults bully you and you stand up for yourself, they tend to try to break you even harder because they know they have the power to do so and get away with it. My fellow classmates, you are entering the world of adults now. I implore you all to fight for yourself, because if you don't, no one else will. Stand up for who you are and what you believe in at all costs. Do not just stay silent, because that is the easy thing to do. This world needs someone to change it. You are the generation that must solve climate change, must solve racial discrimination, must solve every other problem that does not have a solution yet. You must aim to fix a world filled with hate and intolerance to one of respect and acceptance. Luckily, you all have the passion and heart necessary to do so. Although our generation bears a great responsibility, we must not neglect the responsibility we have onto ourselves. We owe it to ourselves to choose happiness. This pandemic has limited us greatly. We have had to stay apart from the people and things we love the most. We have had to postpone our happiness for the safety of others. If this year has taught you anything, let it be to never postpone your happiness again. So go out and enjoy your college years. Find that career that makes your heart sing. Walk a path in life that will give you endless joy. Focus on pursuing your hopes, your dreams, your sincerest wishes, your heart's desires. Do not wait until tomorrow to fulfill them. As you all have seen, tomorrow is not guaranteed. You all should be immensely proud of yourselves. I hope you can enter this new chapter in your life confident that you have what it takes to improve both your life and the lives of those around you. I sincerely congratulate you, class of 2021.
Thank you, Shanaz. I would now ask Ms. Elsie Luque to return to the podium, accompanied by Emilia Samujas, to sing Don't Stop Believing by Journey. So good and a lot of guts. I always say, as a teacher, a parent, and a principal, we as a school have one main goal: to make you well-rounded adults who are prepared for what the world will throw at you. I believe a large part of that comes in your senior year. However, for you guys, your senior year was a little different. You missed a year and a half of in-person school, and while I understand this means you missed in-person class time, you also missed so many important life lessons and moments outside the classroom. You missed a year and a half of extra love and hugs from Miss Giamo. You missed the animated in-person history lessons given by Mr. Hughes that capture you like a blockbuster movie and open your eyes to history not always written in the book. You missed days of real-life advice from our PE staff, jokes with your coaches, a few hundred extra screams from Mr. Mahoney, in-person lunch with Mr. McCann or Mr. Sterling and their wise advice, telling it like it is by Miss Amana, stock tips from me, and life lessons from Dr. Alfonso. All the stuff that comes outside the classroom walls. So to rectify this, to ensure we send you out prepared for what lies ahead, I compiled a list of things you should know before you leave us one last time. One, life does not always play by the rules. Life is not fair. You will hear way more no's than yeses, but a no is never the final answer. A no just means you need to alter your plan to get to the place you were meant to be. Two, Michelangelo said, the greatest danger for most of us is not that our aim is too high and we miss, but that it's too low and we reach it. Michael Jordan said, I missed more than 9,000 shots in my career. I've lost almost 300 games. 26 times I've been trusted to take the game-winning shot and miss. I failed over and over again in my life. And that is why I succeed. The lesson is, push yourself. Success should come from the challenge, not the try. And if you want to get anywhere in life, you need to shoot higher than you ever thought possible. Three, you may not have a chance to change the world, but you will always have the chance to change one person. And you never know if that person may just change the world. Four, know your power. Do not let people treat you badly. Those people think you need them. They think you will not walk away. I'm telling you, run. Run from anyone who does not support the person you are growing to be. Five, the other day my son told me his buddy said they weren't friends anymore. My first reaction as a mom is, why? How can we fix this? but we need to change that train of thought. My reaction instead is, if they don't want to be your friend, that's cool. We'll find people who do. Don't ask why someone doesn't like you. It doesn't matter. Other people will. Those are your people. Accomplish one task a day. As a military daughter, my father always told me the task should be making my bed. I do not make my bed. But I urge you, pick a small, simple task that matters to you every morning. Whether it's making the bed, a run, a meditation. Whatever matters to you, and start doing it every single morning. It will ensure you start every day with a win. 7, create an imaginary island in your mind that you are forced to live on, and pick 5 people and 5 items you would take with you. This is your team, these are the people, and those are the things that matter most. 8, ask for help. You will always look smarter asking a question and doing it right than doing it halfway and getting it wrong. 9, this is a big one. You will not like everyone or even respect everyone's choices, but you will need to learn to work with them if you want to get ahead in life. So learn to fake it. 10, never be the complainer at work. No one wants to hang out with the complainer. And finally, if it doesn't challenge you, test you, or make you a little uncomfortable, you're probably doing it wrong. To the class of 2021, congrats. Mr. Jose Chavez, Board Vice President, by virtue of the authority vested in me by the state of New Jersey as high school principal, I certify that those candidates for graduation here assembled who have completed all of the requirements of the state and local boards of education are thereby eligible to receive their diplomas. It is with great pleasure that I present to you the Bogota Junior Senior High School Class of 2021 and Mr. Jose Chavez.
Right there. Thank you, everyone. On behalf of the Board of Education, I accept the graduates of the class of 2021 assembled here before me. In recognition of the completion of your prescribed course of study, and upon the certification of our principal, I direct that all graduates here assembled receive Bogota Junior Senior High School diplomas with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations.
I will now call the names of our 2021 graduating class. I have been practicing their names all week, so be kind. I ask that you please hold your applause until all names are called. I also want you to let you know that we hired a professional photographer who will be taking pictures of your students receiving their diploma. So we ask that you remain seated. Those will be sent home to you. I ask that the first row please stand. They're ahead of their time. Elsie Luque. Look at him. Ethan Abad. Yeah, I know. Muhammad Ali. Belen E. Auchkila Rivera. Elizabeth Bad Reapersad. Jason Bad Reapersad. Graduating with her high school diploma and her associates from Bergen Community College, Taylor Ann Cabana. Cabana. Okay.
said that whole front thing.
Emma I. Gaizapante. Juan Carlos Castillo. Attending virtually, Ashanti T. Cavanis. Fang Chen. Taj Collins. Jose Manuel Corniel. Graduating with her high school diploma and an associate's from Bergen Community College, Carmen Estella Cruz. Malachi Cullum. Attending virtually, Vanessa De Leon, who earned both her high school diploma and her associate's from Bergen Community College. April Shante Eason. LaShawn Dante Marianne Eason. Your Dallas Fajardo. Sierra A. Felice. Alexis Fernandez. Chloe A. Fotopoulos. Attending virtually, Jalen Fuller. Julian P. Garcia. Anahi Garcia Morales. Rachel A. Rosha Gushkem. Nathaniel J. Guzman. Janelle Hamilton. David D. Hanau Vivas. Camilo Hernandez. Aaliyah Natasha Hidalgo. Joshua John Igo. Delon Jackson. Annie Jimenez. Yusef Laik Ahmed. I now call up current councilwoman and former Board of Ed member, Connie Carpenter. Dylan Bradley LeMay. Adam L. Magbag. Daniela Fernanda Maroon. Elizabeth Marie Martinez. Esteban Daniel Martinez. Melanie Christine Medina. Earning her high school diploma and her associate's degree from Bergen Community College, Shanaz Uden. Watching virtually, Sasha F. Mehta. Alexander Rich Melendez. Jesus Michelle. Elvis Jeremy Mock. Brianna Faith Mancho. Jade Montalvo. Yorlin Montolio. Hey, Yorlin. Matthew Montoya. Yeah, Matthew. Yalitza Saret Morales. Luis A. Mota Mendez. Bisma Mudisser. Michaela D. Munoz. Nixilis Nunez. I would now like to call up current Board of Ed member, John Ortega. Johnny L. Ortega. Watching virtually, Kevin Perez. Kiera Polanco. Flavio C. Kishpi Vavar. William P. Kishpi. Ryan Christopher Ramirez. Graduating with her high school diploma and an associate's degree from Bergen Community College, Emily Recio. Ruby A. Recio. Yeah, Andres Abel Rodriguez. Good. Katie Jasmine Rodriguez. Graduating with his high school diploma and an associate's degree from Bergen Community College, Leandro Rojas. Riza Victoria Rojas. Yaire A. Romero. Carlos H. Rondon. Damaris Rosario. Christos Stratos Samujas. Emilia Sumujas. Edward Sanchez. Cynthia K. Tenazaka. Joanna Sophia Teneo. Edwin J. Tirado. Dennis E. Toremus. Emerald N. Torres. Gabriella N. Torres. Not to be outdone by his sister, graduating with a high school diploma and an associate's from Bergen Community College, Shabazz Uden. Albiri Urena. Amber Vasquez. Watching virtually, William Weiskis. Oh, no, he here. William, I promise I didn't forget you. Watching virtually, Carl Williams. And finally, Anisha A. Wilson. I now present to you the class of 2021. We now approach the more somber part of our ceremony, one that is filled with tradition, with the recitation of the ephebic oath. The ephebic oath, which is the traditional oath of graduates across our country, will be led by class officers President Carmen Cruz and Vice President Emily Recio, and can be found in your program. We invite all seniors to join in once Carmen and Emily begin. This will then be followed by our senior class officers presenting the class of 2021 senior gift.
With gratitude to my school, with pride in my community, and with devotion to my country, I pledge, as a graduate, to cherish the traditions of Bogota Junior Senior High School, as a citizen to work both alone and with many to improve my community, and as an American, to obey my country's laws and to support and defend its constitution.
Good evening. My name is Taylor Cabana. This year, Elsie Luque, Emily Recio, Carmen Cruz, and I had the great honor of serving as a senior class officers. Today, we are proud to continue this tradition of the senior class gift. The senior class gift is an opportunity for the graduating class to leave behind a legacy for future classes while honoring our past as Bogota Junior Senior High School graduates. It is also a way for us to thank the school for all the experiences and support it has given us over the past 4 years. The class of 2021 is proud to leave behind a statue of a pillar with a book resting atop it. The pillar will be engraved with class of 2021, and the book will be engraved with the school's alma mater. It will stand as a reminder of the pride BHS students should have in their school, which helped shape many successful and prosperous individuals and will continue to do so as long as it stands. A special thanks goes out to our esteemed board members, our hard at work PTO, our administrators and teachers, and our lovely senior class advisors, Ms. Krugnola and Ms. Fry. Without your assistance, we would not have been able to fulfill so many traditions throughout this unprecedented year. We are deeply thankful for all the assistance and support you have shown to our class. We hope that this gift will become a symbol of pride for the school. Thank you, Bogota Junior Senior High School, for everything.
Thank you to our class officers and the class of 2021. I would now ask everyone to listen and feel free to sing along as Elsie Luque leads the class in the singing of the alma mater, written by Sheik Eastwood, class of 32.
In future years, when life's a play and we are gray, let come what may, our thoughts revert to the days of old when we staked our all on the purple and gold. There's a castle built on the place where friends are made. It's a stepping stone to college, where our path of life is laid. Although the world we travel round, joy we found at our dear Bogota High.
Would the graduating class of 2021 please stand? Our class president will now lead the class in her last official act as senior class president, and that is to move the tassel to the position of graduate, which is to the left. And I would like to offer my sincere congrats to the class of 2021 and thank you all for sharing in this special occasion. Give it up one more time for the class of 2021. Oh,